You have questions?
Yeah, what's the song about?
This is one of the first songs. This was one of the first songs I wrote in New Orleans when I was working there on Bourbon Street, which was 1967. And that was like it. That was as high as I could ever get in show business. I've been playing bars all over the South, all over the Gulf Coast, not the South. And then I played a place called Trader John's, which was like the minor leagues, but the Bayou Room on Bourbon Street was like, that's, you made it. And I made $150 a week. And I had a bar tab, and I got a discount. And my first week that I worked there, I went to get my check, and I owed them money. Because I'd oversigned and buying people drinks and me drinks. And on the first week there, I drank more than I made. So that's true stuff. But I was, you know, I was enraptured with New Orleans from my childhood, and then all the stories of all the great writers and musicians in the town were just, and I couldn't believe that I'd actually made it to what at that time was the top folk club in the Gulf Coast. So I was living that life and starting to write, but like I said, working on Bourbon Street, particularly the club owners who are kind of junior mafia guys, they did not relish original songs. You were there to entertain the crowd and play the hits. And that was the job. Of course, you did it. But every now and then, you try to sneak one in on a late, late night show, probably after Paul LaMarca had gone home. You'd sneak one in, and we had local people that were fans and musicians, and that's how you kind of got your material into the show. And this was one of the first songs I wrote in New Orleans, and I used to, there actually was a streetcar named Desire Like the Play, because that was always such to me a great title, but it really was the name of a street in French Quarter that Tennessee Williams used. But the actual streetcar, in those days, New Orleans was pretty funky. It didn't have the kind of, you know, kind of high-end tourist attractions it had. So this streetcar just sat by itself with maybe a little plaque in front of it down by the Café. There was the Café du Monde, was one of those beignet places, but that was kind of touristy. And on the other end of the French Market was the Morning Call. That's where locals went. And right next to it was this streetcar, a streetcar named Desire. It had it on there. And you could just get on it. And I would sit on there like in the morning or if I was getting home from work late, it would be early in the morning. I'd get some beignets and a Café du Monde, and I'd write there on the streetcar hoping that, you know, of course I knew Tennessee Williams had never written on the streetcar, but I'm sure he'd ridden on the streetcar. So I was just trying to conjure up some Tennessee Williams or some William Faulkner there. And there were a lot of hippies and a lot of hobos down there. And it was also around the time that the great book Confederacy of Dunces was done about street life in New Orleans. So I wanted to do a song about street life in New Orleans, and this was it. And it was called The Wino and I Know. Take 54. I scream that he's a hillbilly fan, got 78 by Hank Snow. Walks through the streets of the city so deep, a city that only he knows. And I've seen him so many places, trusting. It's a strange situation, wild occupation, living my life like a song. Sweet senorita, please come with me. Back to the island, honey, back to the sea. Back to the only place I wanna be. Like a boy knows the joy of a milkshake in motion. It's a strange situation, wild occupation, living my life like a song. Yes, it's a strange situation, wild occupation, living my life like a song.
I love that song.
I do too.
It conjures up memories.